I was recently approached by one of my newsletter subscribers asking for help. This photographer had been trying to recreate an abstract art effect for his photography using Affinity Photo. So in this video, I'll show you how to produce this image step by step. The effect is created by blending multiple exposures to produce an abstract artistic photo. Although we could create these in the camera, we can also reproduce the effect here using Affinity Photo. The first thing that you'll need to do is select a photo to use. I've found the best results come from images like this with lots of detail. The tangle of branches and leaves means that we can produce interesting patterns for the brain to latch onto. I'm starting with the image open in Affinity Photo's Photo Persona. To create the effect, we need different exposures to blend into one. The alternative to using different images is to blend a second copy of the current image, which is what I'll do in this tutorial. Duplicate the image layer by right-clicking on it in the Layers Studio panel and selecting the Duplicate option. I now have two identical images in the Layers Studio panel. If you were going to do this with different photos, you would have the two images on separate layers in the same document. Let's change the size of the new layer to make it much larger than the original image. I'll use the Move tool for this, which you can select in the Affinity Photo Tools palette. To make it easier to work, reduce the image size in the Navigator panel. Now I can click the corner of the image and drag it using the Move tool to resize it. Resizing it means that the two images look different. I can also use the Move tool to reposition the visible area of the larger layer. If I now reduce the opacity of the top layer, it allows the original image to show through and we start to see the abstract effect. A useful tip is that I can double-click now on the background layer to return the image to fill the screen. To improve the look of the image, I want to show more of the original tree trunk through the leaves using the layer mask. I can add the layer mask by clicking the mask icon at the bottom of the Layer Studio panel. Depending on your Affinity setup, this is either attached to a layer or as a separate layer. You can easily remove or attach a layer mask to a layer by clicking and dragging it in the Layer Studio panel. Next, I'll select the Paintbrush tool and set the opacity to about 50%. I'll also ensure that I paint with the brush hardness of 0%. This creates a soft edge to the brush, blending the effect into the image. I'll then paint black onto the layer mask where I want to hide the top layer. This will allow the tree trunk to show through. At the moment, I can't see where the tree trunk is, so I need to set the layer's opacity to 0. Now I can see the tree trunk, I can paint over it. Before starting to paint, I'll be sure to select the layer mask to ensure I'm painting onto that. After applying a first pass over the tree trunks and branches, I can hold down my Option key and click on the mask. If you're using a Windows PC, that's your Alt key. This displays the black and white mask, which I can then paint over a second time. I can then click on the duplicate layer thumbnail to return to the image. Now I can return the layer's opacity to around 50%, or a level that's suitable for your image. You can also paint over the mask again to show the tree trunks more clearly. Let's now duplicate the layer a second time. As before, right-click on the layer and select the Duplicate option. This will duplicate both the layer and the layer mask. This time, let's click and drag the mask, dropping it onto the dustbin icon. You don't have to delete the mask, but if you don't, you'll need to reposition it if you move the layer. I find that it's better to delete the mask and then add a second copy later. We will now change the layer's opacity mode from Normal to Overlay. Then, using the Move tool, click and drag the duplicate layer to reposition it on the image. I've found that moving it a small distance from its original position produces a nice multiple exposure effect and it helps to give the image an abstract look. We will then duplicate the layer again. As before, right-click on the layer and choose the duplicate option. We can then move this a small amount from its current position to produce a blurring effect. At this stage, we already have a nice abstract artistic photo. Looking at the image, I want the tree trunks to be more evident in the scene. I'll therefore duplicate my original layer mask by right-clicking and selecting the duplicate option. I'm aware that I deleted the layer mask previously. Had I not done that, it would still be attached to the image, but in the wrong position. If you reposition an image layer with a layer mask attached, you must also move the mask. I'm also going to change the blending mode of the top layer. This is currently overlay, but the color burn blend mode also produces a nice effect with strong color. As a final step in the editing, I'll add a new curves adjustment layer to the top of the image. I can do this by clicking the top layer and then choosing the adjustments icon at the bottom of the Layers Studio panel. In the pop-up list, pick the curves adjustment layer. I can then adjust the curve to refine the effect. I'm now going to place all the layers into a group. With the top layer selected, hold down the Shift key and click on the bottom duplicate layer. This selects all the adjustment layers in the image. I can then click the group layer icon at the bottom of the Layers Studio panel. Now with the layers in a single group, I can reduce the opacity to control the effect, or I can turn off the layers to compare it to the original. The multiple exposure layers in this image have created an impressive abstract artistic effect. But did you know you can create the same effect using the Knit Collection? This video explains how and is a good one to watch next. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Please share it with others and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I'll see you soon for another video.